Students, the coming to the next topic, that is the 8051 pin diagram. So in the previous video I explained about the architecture of 8051, that is a microcontroller. Now let us see what is a pin diagram, how the pin diagram will represent that 8051 microcontroller. So this is a 40 pin deep Julian package. So one side you are having 20 pins and another side you are having the 20 pins. So this is 8051 microcontroller. The microcontroller means you are having everything inbuilt. Means along with the microprocessor, you are having the inbuilt RAM, ROM, timers or counters and some special function. So everything will be present inside the microcontroller. Whereas in microprocessor, only the CPU, that is a central processing unit, ALU, registers and control unit will be present in microprocessor, and all the components that are RAM, ROM and some counter timers and counter registers, everything will be connected externally to that pin. Okay, so that is the main difference between the microcontroller and the microprocessor. Again, I am repeating that so that you won't be forget what is that microcontroller and the microprocessor. Okay, so now let us see this microcontroller 8051 microcontroller. It's a 40 pin deep. Here you can see these are the three ports will be present: port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 0. So total 4 ports, you call it as a banks. Now let us see each and every pin clearly. First take 1 to 8 pins. So 1 to 8 pins, these are port P1.0, 1.2 up to 1.7. So this is an 8-bit port. These pins are known as port 1. First of all, these pins are known as port 1. This port does not serve any other function. Okay, it is internally pulled up bidirectional IO ports. Just it acts as an input output ports. Other than that, it cannot do any other function. Means it cannot take any other information. So that's why we didn't write anything here. So in the port 3, you are writing some of the functions that are the operations that the pins can handle. But the port 1, that is 1.0 to 1.7, this port does not serve any other functions other than input output ports. It can act only as input port as well as output port. Okay, so 1 to 8 is over. Now coming to the next pin, that is a pin 9. So what is the use of this pin 9? RST. RST is nothing but the reset pin, which is used to reset the microcontroller to its initial value. So whatever the starting that 8051 is having, it comes to the initial values, initial position. Whenever you make it as a reset, whenever you just make the reset is equal to 1, means it all the microcontroller instructions are reset to its initial values. Now coming to the next, 10 to 17. 10 to 17 means this is a port 3. These pins are known as port 3. Let me write first. This is the port 3 pins. This port serves some functions like interrupt, timer input, control signals, serial communication signals, that is a receiver and transmit, receive data and transmit data. P3.0 is acts as a receive data and 3.1 as a transmit data, and this is the interrupt 0 and interrupt 1 signals, so acts as an interrupt functions, and this is a timer input, timer 0 and timer 1, and the control signals, these are the control signals, read signal, write signal and the read signal. Okay, so etc. So these pins from 10 to 7, this port 3 can act as some, it can perform some different functions like this: interrupts, timers, control signals, and the it's a serial communication signals like read data and transmit, receive data and transmit data. Sorry, so these are two of the serial communication signals: receive data and the transmit data. Now coming to the 18th pin. Here 18th and 19th, you can see these pins are used for interfacing an external crystals to get the system clock. X is nothing but external crystal will be connected to this two pins so that it can get the system clock, to get the system clock. Okay, so is it clear up to here? And the 20 pin is the ground pin. this pin provides the ground to the circuit. So 1 to 20, 1 to 8 access and port 1, it access and input output ports, and 10 to 17, that is the port 3, will perform different functions like receive data, transmit data, interrupt 0, interrupt 1, and T0 and T1 are the timers, and control signals read, write and read. And this 2 pins are for external crystals, and this is a ground pin. Now coming to the next. Pin 21 to 28. Pin 21 to 28 is a port 2. This is a port 2 pins. So this port 2 pin serves as an input output port, and as well as higher order address bus signals are also multiplexed using this. So these are the higher order address bus. So A8 to A15 is a higher order address bus. So these ports acts as an input output port, and as well as it acts as an higher order address bus, so that you have to be remembered. Next is the 29th pin. The 29th pin is the program store enable. PSEN means program store enable. So what's the use of this pin? It is used to read a signal from external program memory. So whatever the external program memory is there, that will be read by this PSEN, program store enable. Now coming to the 30th pin, address latch enable pin. So this address will be enabled by using this pin. And 31 pin. 31 is this access a EA. This EA pin, which stands for external access. This is external access. EA means external access. We have to access from external device. External access. It is used to enable or disable the external memory interface. So external access is name itself is saying we have to access the data from external devices. So this pin makes the enable or disable the external memory interface. External memory interface. So that is the use of this pin. Now coming to 32 to 39. So this is a port 0. So this port 0 serves as input output port, and here the lower address AD0 to AD7, lower order address and data signals are multiplexed, both are multiplexed. So port 0 serves as input output port, and lower order data, so D0 to D7 data, and address A0 to A7 address signals are multiplexed, means both are combined, multiplexed using this port. So port 0 acts as an input output port, at the same time it acts as a multiplexed address and data bus, that is the two lower order. And here port 2 acts as an input output port and higher order address bus. It acts as a higher order address bus. And port 3 will serve different functions. Receive data, transmit data, interrupt timer, read and write signals. And whereas port 1 is only used to serve the input output ports. Other than that, it doesn't do any function. So these are the four ports that are present in 8051 microcontroller. And VCC is used to provide power supply to the circuit. So this is about the pin diagram of 8051 microcontroller. Thank you.